As the program went on and Daddy Gio said all our aches and pains are healed, I checked my waist, bent over double, and was completely gone. I bless the name of the Lord for the flood of healing. Amen. We have another testifier from Spain, a brother. The doctor said the wife could not conceive again after they had had a child. But at the December 2013 Congress, they joined online for the first time. And in 2014, the Lord gave his family a baby girl after 8 years of waiting. Praise the name of the Lord. We have a testifier who sent in an online testimony from Nigeria, a lady, that at the December 2014 Holy Ghost Congress, the word of knowledge came that God is sending a blanket of healing to someone, and she grabbed it. She had a case of kidney disease. By the end of that same month, December 2014, the Lord healed her completely without taking any medication up till now, and she's praising the name of the Lord. Let somebody shout hallelujah. Amen. We'll now take testifiers for tonight. Sister Esther Omotoke.
My name is Sister Omotoke Estala. I've been believing God for the fruit of womb for the past 13 years. But last year, I decided to do something extra. The first thing I did last year was to partake in the 100-day fasting and prayer. And the second thing that I did was I entered into contribution just because I want to sow into the new auditorium. I did the contribution, and I collected it, and I sold it to the new auditorium. The third one, last year convention, and I came, and I was weeping seriously. On Sunday, after the ordination of the full pastor, I decided to stay back, and I started picking the floor. I picked it to the extent that my back was aching me, and I was telling God, by this time next year, I want to come back here and testify to your glory. And on September, Daddy mentioned my case. And to the glory of God, September 21st this year, God gave me this bundle of joy. Her name is Testimony Toluwa Lashe, Oluwa Murewa, Good News, Faith, Ilealu Oluwa Kiishu. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. We'll take the next testifier, please.
Praise the Lord! Oruko mi ni Mrs. V.O. Aliu. Mo dupe lowo Olorun fun igbala okan mi. Year 2006, I was si Congress bayi. I wa n pada lo si ile pada. Ati de challenge. Moto ta wo ngba yen accident. Mi o mo aye eyan to ku nu e o mo wa dupe lowo Olorun oba to pa mi mo to da mi si oba ti o dojo adura ti mi mo dupe lowo Olorun idile to ti bi mi mo dupe lowo Olorun idile ti mo tun bara mi won wa nso fun mi pe se bo lo lo pe Jesu se o tan ese meji o di tan kurukunu mo wa dupe lowo Olorun mo nso fo Olorun ni usage mo loluwa se o gbo ntan so Olorun na ku o gbadọ wu ese isan tese ibasan tin ba le fi duro ma wa jeri si agbara Olorun mo wa dupe lowo Olorun pe ese mejeji na ni mo fi duro. Praise the Lord. Emi na re.
Hallelujah.
The testimony of our mommy was that she came for the Congress of 2006, and after the Congress, while she was traveling back to Ibadan, there was an accident. And in the course of that, she had some broken legs, and she now prayed that if the Lord could heal her and she could walk on those two legs, she would come here to testify. We cannot see her marching on those two legs, and she's now praising the Lord for giving her the miracle of healing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Oruko mi ni Ope Odu Adelaja. Ni ijo keta ojude oba ti won se koja yi ni October. Mo gbe machine, mo gbe lo si Saki. Nigba ti mo de ohun, mo ni accident lohun. Awon ti le npe mi, mi o fe lawon fun won pe mo ti ni accident. Sugbon accident yen o wa je pe egungun eyin mi o ye. Mo sa ndogbon, mo ndogbon, sugbon ngba ti wo di nkan bi osu kan ti isele yen isele si mi, mo wa ri pe eyin mi ti gba oyun jo. So wahala yen de ba mi, mi o le sun, mi o le wo. Mo sa mo lo si general hospital ni ilu Ijebu-Ode. Doctor wo won na ma se o ma sise fun beyen ni won de sise si beyen won la oyun jade nbe mo dupe yen lowo Olorun nigba ti mo ta dele leyin osu kan ti won la beyen se lesa mejeji se loro mi o le gbese mejeji mo nigba to wife mo ni an lo si pago mo ni mi o lo si pago nitori pe mi o de bi bayi ri edi ni ojo akoko ti ma de bi bayi mo ni mi o de bi bayi ri mo ni mi o lo asaja ngba te yo odijo kiji mo le ba won mo ni je ka ma lo ba si gbe la niyan ta n bo ni ipago ngba ta de pago mo n te opa ni lati Ijebu-Ode mo n te opa fun odin di ose meta nigba ti mo n te opa yi ti mo fi opa yi rin kai kiri nigba ti mo de bi gan mo tu te opa de bi bayi sugbon ngba ti awon daddy wa se program awon daddy Olorun daddy Gio ti won se program ni ale Monday ti won ni eyin ti e gbagbo pe ka jade ka ma bo 1 2 to be si ni ka ti mo be si ni saire eye ti mo sa yen ese yen de fo lo mo dupe lowo Olorun ese na ni mo dupe lowo Olorun.
Praise the Lord.
This testimony of our brother was after the Ojude Oba festival in Ijebu-Ode. He traveled to Saki. There he had an accident and the backbone was broken. After which they operated upon it. Immediately after that, the two legs became withered. But the wife now persuaded him to come here during this Congress. He was reluctant. He came here walking with a stick. On that Monday, when our father in the Lord made altar call for those who want to give their life to Jesus Christ, he ran towards the altar. Suddenly, the two legs received life, and we can see him marching with.
Our last testifier for
tonight. Somebody pray the Lord. Hallelujah! I'm Grace Obidiah from Rivers Province 1. On Sunday, after church, we closed very late. So I was in the church around past 2. A friend of mine called me and said, they have kidnapped one of my friends. Over a week plus, the people have not called to negotiate. I said, what is happening? Then my sister and pastor was still in church. I called him, I said, please, let us pray for my friend. She has 5 children. They are too small. So we prayed for her. So 3, 5 minutes to 3, I have to go home. Because I normally have 1 hour worship from 3 to 4 every day. So when I get home, I started the first song, the second song. As I was worshiping God, my phone rang. I said, for my brother and wife to call me. She knows that I will be in mood of prayer by now. Maybe there is something wrong. I picked the phone. She said, Grace, I know you're praying. Begin to pray. They have kidnapped her until now. She returned from church and they have kidnapped her. I begin to, God, what do I do now? I need to sing like Paul and Silas. Let earthquake begin to move in the range of the kidnappers. I prayed. I called the pastors that I know. They said, from now to Sunday. I said, from now to Sunday is too far. My family have a covenant with God. My sister does not need to be in the midst of the kidnapper for 24 hours. We begin to pray. Even when I was coming to conversion, I was coming with faith that when I'm here, God is going to release my sister.
On Tuesday evening, they called. On Tuesday morning, they called. And they said, we should pay them 10 million. I shouted. I said, where are we going to get 10 million? I was at the back of the altar praying. I heard some brothers from Edo. They are singing praises. I met them. I was crying. I said, my sisters in the custody of the kidnappers. I want us to pray. Lord, we will pray. And we decree on this redemption ground. And God opened heaven. And the floodgate of heaven was open. My sister is now released. Then my friend, they refused to call.
Hallelujah.
Now they have called them.
Praise the Lord. Please, shall we rise to our feet? We need to give God thanks. We have had that testimonies are given by